In this tutorial, I will show you how and where to use resistors in a circuit and types of resistors. Let's get started. When you want to turn on an LED, it is easy just by directly connecting it to the power supply, only in the case of a lower voltage. But when we are forced to use a higher voltage, in this case a 20 volts, the LED dies immediately as soon as when I connect it. So how can we prevent it? And here comes the role of the resistor. It can solve the problem by limiting the excess current flowing in the circuit and dissipating it in the form of heat. For the circuit, we can place the resistor in series anywhere between the source and load. Now by connecting the same 20 volts, the LED lights up perfectly without getting destroyed. So we can use the same resistor for bigger load, right? Well, it's not. Because this resistor cannot handle high power due to its limitations. Resistors comes in many power ratings. Quarter watt, half watt, 1 watt, 2 watt, 5 watt and so on. When we line them up, we can see the difference in core size to dissipate the heat without burning itself. Now to get different resistance value, we can either put them up in series to increase the resistance or in parallel to decrease the resistance. Or we may simply use another type of resistor called potentiometer or variable resistor, which contains 3 terminals instead of 2. Why? When I measure up across the ends, I get fixed resistance value. But when I switch any one of the leads to the middle terminal, I get variable resistance value by rotating the knob in either direction. This potentiometer comes in various sizes and shapes. This one is a multi-turn potentiometer, which gives precise value of resistance since its name itself say a multi-turn. This one is a trim pot, which also does the same function but smaller in size. These types of potentiometers are often found in measuring instruments. Have you ever wondered how joystick or gamepad's analog stick works? Now you may see, it also contains one of these trimmer potentiometers on either sides for X and Y directions. And even a servo motor circuit contains one of these kind. All the above things which we have seen is the linear type resistors. Now coming to the example of non-linear type resistors. Some of them are light dependent resistor, frequently referred to LDR, whose resistance decreases when light's intensity increases on its surface, and the other way around. This one right in my hand is a flexible resistor called thermistor, whose resistance is based upon temperature. These are negative temperature coefficient, as a decrease in temperature increases its resistance. This can be used as a crude temperature sensor. You can even create a simple resistor at home just by using a pencil and paper. As pencil contains graphite, it possesses some electrical resistance. Now when I move the probes, the resistance varies, which is seen in multimeter. Even a piece of wire contains some resistance, which depends upon the material, cross-sectional area and length. If you feel this video is helpful, give me a like, share this video, subscribe to my channel and stay tuned for more awesome electronics basics.